I do see that there is a continuous kind of a building of ties between the KIO and the Kachins as a whole.
No one wants war. The truth is, every human being desires to live in peace with dignity. There are numerous reasons why Myanmar still lacks any clear plan for achieving peace. After Myanmar's independence in 1948, the Kachin Independence Organization, whose armed struggle has continued for nearly 60 years, has engaged with consecutive military regimes numerous times to push for political dialogue to end the conflict. This included meetings with the Revolutionary Council in 1963 and 1972, the Burma Socialist Program Party in 1980 and 1981, and also with the former president U San Yeol in the 1980s, none of which were successful in achieving the desired political dialogue. On February 24, 1994, the KIO signed a ceasefire agreement with the ruling military regime of the State Law and Order Restoration Council. The ceasefire period provided the KIO with opportunities to carry out development projects for the local communities, including construction of hydropower dams and building basic infrastructure such as roads and bridges. The same agreement allowed the military government, in the name of economic development, to enter and take control of the areas which it didn't have access to previously. The agreement led to rapid expansion of natural resource extraction activities, including jade mines, gold mines, and excessive logging in natural forests. Agreements were also signed with Chinese companies for construction of hydropower projects, including the Mitsone Mega Dam project. During the ceasefire period, the lack of continuing political dialogue between the KIO and Myanmar government led to a worsening of the situation over time. The increasing deployment and expansion of army posts in Kachin State was creating an atmosphere of fear and insecurity. On June 9, 2011, the Burmese military initiated an attack near Taping Hydropower Project, citing KIO's liaison office as the target. It ended the 17-year-old long ceasefire. The fighting has since spread to other parts of Kachin State and displaced more than 120,000 individuals to date. A total of 367 villages, 14,980 houses, and 272 religious buildings, including churches, have been destroyed due to the fighting.
I mean, I covered the civil war in Burma for more than 30 years, and I've never seen such heavy fighting as now, since the peace process was launched, since the 1980s. And that we have more IDPs now than ever before in the history of Burma Civil War.
The KIO made many attempts to stop the fighting and find a peaceful way to return to a ceasefire. On June 16, 2011, following the escalation of armed conflict between the KIA and the Burmese army, the KIO reached out to Member of Parliament Thein Zaw to act as a mediator in meetings with the army. On June 30, 2011, representatives from the KIO and the army met in the KIO-administered township of Lajayang. Despite this meeting, the level of fighting was not reduced. On November 29, 2011, the KIO delegation met with a union-level delegation for peace negotiation led by Ong Tong in Rili, Yunnan province in China. Following more meetings, the KIO leadership actively took part in the United Nationalities Federal Council, an umbrella organization for ethnic armed organizations, to work towards first creating a ceasefire and then a peace process based on political dialogue. While the KIO was searching for ways to achieve peace, the Burmese army used military force to seize many of the KIA's strategic military posts. On November 19, 2014, the Burmese army's heavy artillery shelling hit the KIO officer school, killing 23 young cadets. The unprovoked attack caused the peace negotiations to stop at that time.
You now have a moment of remarkable opportunity to transform ceasefires into lasting settlements and to pursue peace where conflicts still linger, including Kachin State. Those efforts must lead to a more just and lasting peace, including humanitarian access to those in need and a chance for the displaced to return home.
ကျမတို့ကိုနိုင်ငံတော်မှာလည်းပဲပြည်ပြည်တို့ခုဆိုရင်တခုပဲ
The failure of Myanmar's peace process is directly related to the problematic 2008 constitution. In any country, the constitution serves as a supreme law and foundation for the entire legal system. Myanmar's 2008 constitution was drafted by the military to serve its own interests and is the major obstacle to achieving genuine peace.
ချင်းချင်းပြောရလို့ရှိရင်တော့ ဒါကဒီဥပဒေပညာသားပါပါနဲ့2000ကြီးခွဲစည်းအောင်မှာထိန်းချုပ်ခံထားလိုက်ရတယ်။ဒီဟာငင်းချင်းရေးစာချုပ်ဖြစ်တယ်ဆိုရင်ဒီငင်းချင်းရေးစာချုပ်ကတပီလုံးမှာရှိတဲ့ဥပဒေအကုန်လုံးပြောင်းမြန်လှန်ခွင့်ရှိတဲ့စာချုပ်ဖြစ်ရတယ်။ဆိုတော့ဒီစာချုပ်ကဖွဲ့စည်းပုံအခြေခံဥပဒေကိုချက်ချင်းအသိရေးဆွဲနိုင်လို့ရှိရ။ဒါကြောင့်ခဏိအခုဒီ
ကျွန်တော်ပြောသွားမယ်လွတ်တော်သွားအဲ့လွတ်တော်ပါလွတ်တော်နေနှစ်တောင်းကြီးဖွဲ့စည်းပုံနဲ့အညီလက်ရှိနေလွတ်တော်အဲ့လွတ်တော်ပါသူတွေလဲဆိုတော့၄ဘုံတဘုံကအားလုံးတည်တဲ့အတိုင်းပဲကဘာဘူးအစီချုပ်ကလွတ်တဲ့ပုံကိုများကဒီဘုံလုံးနေရာကိုတားလိုက်တယ်ဘလော့ဘုံတင်ဖြစ်နေ။၂၀၁၈ခံဥပဒေကိုကျွန်တော်ခရိုင်ကိုအနေနဲ့ကတော့ဟိုလက်မခံနိုင်ဘူးလို့ကျွန်တော်တရားဝင်ကြီးညာထားတာဖြစ်
The root cause of Myanmar's prolonged civil war stems from political inequality. In order to find a political solution, more than 20 ethnic armed organizations have numerous times attempted to negotiate with the Burmese army. One of the main reasons why some groups, including the KIO, haven't signed the NCA is the Burma Army's divide and rule policy, leaving out several ethnic groups from participating in the process. An active and founding member of the UNFC, the KIO withdrew its membership from the umbrella group on
July 2017.
NCA ကသူတို့ကမျှော်မှန်းတဲ့နိုင်ငံရေးအဆင့်ကိုမရောက်သေးဘဲနဲ့အတင်းအကျပ်ရပ်ပြီးလက်မှတ်ထိုးတဲ့အထက်မှာသူတို့ကလက်နက်ခံပြီးအဲ NCA ကသူတို့ကမျှော်မှန်းတဲ့နိုင်ငံရေးအဆင့်ကိုမရောက်သေးဘဲနဲ့အတင်းအကျပ်ရပ်ပြီးလက်မှတ်ထိုးတဲ့အထက်မှာသူတို့ကလက်နက်ခံပြီးအဲ NCA ကသူတို့ကမျှော်မှန်းတဲ့နိုင်ငံရေးအဆင့်ကိုမရောက်သေးဘဲနဲ့အတင်းအကျပ်ရပ်ပြီးလက်မှတ်ထိုးတဲ့အထက်
So I think it's in that context one should see the fact that the KAO has left the UNFC and been aligned with the WHA. On the one hand, it's Chinese pressure, but on the other, it's also frustrations with the West. Why didn't the West be more sympathetic to our cause? Why did they abandon us like this? So basically, the West left the Kachins with no choice other than to make an alliance with the WHA.
ကျွန်တော်ပြောသလိုပေါ့เนาะကဲဦးကတော့စကရေကကျွန်တော်တို့အင်စီခုမပြောခင်ကရေကကျွန်တော်တို့ယူအက်ဖ်စီမှာဦးဆောင်အဖွဲ့အစည်းတစ်ခုနေပါခဲ့တာလေဆိုတော့လက်ဦးတုံးကတော့ကျွန်တော်တို့ယူအက်ဖ်စီနေနဲ့သွားမယ်ဆိုပြီးတော့ပြင်ခဲ့တုန်းကကဲဦးကဦးဆောင်အဖွဲ့အစည်းနေပါခဲ့တာနောက်ပိုင်းမှာမှကျွန်တော်တို့ယူအက်ဖ်စီအဖွဲ့ဝင်တွေနဲ့အဖွဲ့မဝင်တွေအဖွဲ့အစည်းကြီးချာမှာပေါင်းဖက် Nitansu the Poang and I Yangon got Krumere. The Krumash Lemon, NC Lam Lamarendu Tushie, Lamantai, Capcade Lamotin Yang right on I. I'm the NC Ndu Tudimon, the Nine and Long, Mundan Ding, Capcat King and Lampet, Ndogoga, and a UNFC, Nungbo Murangai, the one Balago Name, Tamudun Lamna. And they got Dong San Suchi, she could not moon, and they got Antino, Chrublara, eh? Manasune. And that Chrublaga, and Tamu, Gay, Glam Nana, in Jay, Shong Lam de Gomjan Pindonga, Yong Si Krum Donga, Mungshua Chamjo Donga, Tamjogo, Nante Gonan Jin Murangadamu, Ante, Lana Lang Pung Pong, you got Namatang, Capcat Chicken and Lampet, and Dogosanang, and Asun and Lampet Nalu. They read Dong San Suchi could now add the Nante Kunasha, the pet that Capcat Chicken and Kugo, Manuai. Tam yo chen dap te pu duen na me chup bai, pu duen to me chien ya in dao yang she mai ai ngan na sun le. Tam yo chen dap te no chup bai ngan na sun le. Ya deni du kha, chup bai lam mu, mu ma da le yi.
Well, it's not for me to say whether it's right or wrong, but I can say that I understand why they didn't sign, why the KO did not sign this new ceasefire agreement. Because first of all, they already had a ceasefire agreement with the government, which was violated. Two, the whole peace process. So-called peace process been launched by the previous government and the present government is putting the cart before the horse. You want everyone to sign an agreement first, then there will be talks, political talks, after they signed the agreement. But I mean, this is not how you make peace anywhere in the world. Normally, the government would announce a ceasefire. Okay, we stop fighting now. It's fine. We freeze our positions, no more shooting. Easy, it's not difficult at all. Then you sit down and you talk, you reach a consensus, you sign an agreement. But here, they want everyone to sign the agreement first, and then sometime in the future, there may be some political talks. That's not going to work.
I think that I can clearly say that I do not doubt their sincerity. There's no question that the question is really of what that, how that translates into the nitty-gritty of substantive issues. And invariably, their experience will place them in a much more, and will embitter them a lot more in terms of taking the statements on the other side at face value. Now, you must recognize that from the same, from the point of view of the perspective of the army and the military, the government, they may also have these kind of inhibitions, which may have been generated over years of the experience of the fighting on their part.
Most importantly, the current NCA structure will not lead Myanmar to achieve sustainable peace.
ဒီကဟိုအောင်မြင်နိုင်ဖို့အတွက်ကျွန်တော်တို့ရဲ့ဟိုအမြင်ကတော့ဟိုအချက်ပေါင်းများကြီးရှိတဲ့အထက်မှာတက်ချက်ကတော့တစ်ဖက်နဲ့တစ်ဖက်ယုံယုံကြည်ကြည်ဆွေးနွေးဖို့လိုပါတယ်တကယ်လို့ကျွန်တော်တို့ကလည်းဖက်လက်ခံနိုင်တဲ့ဟိုအပြစ်ခရရစေးစာချုပ်ချုပ်ဆိုပြီးတဲ့အခါမှာဆွေးနွေးပွဲတွေလုပ်နေတဲ့အချိန်မှာဟိုအပြစ်ခရရစေးကိုလုပ်ထားပြီးတစ်ဖက်နဲ့တစ်ဖက်နောက်ထပ်ဖြစ